Hello everybody and welcome back to Bjornholm, the best man mushroom. How you gals and guys doing? I hope you're doing good. Sorry I've been away for a bit. Been a bit manic in the panda household. Real life, so that's as much as I'm saying about that. But I hope all you guys have been okay. And you're having a nice summer. Our summer's a bit, yeah, ain't all that. Yeah, of course, every point is done. Want to compromise, yeah. What we're doing, we're basically just harvesting and sorting out our plant to what field are we on? 38. Okay. We're sorting out our industry. I've got a couple of new mods in, but field 38. Where is it? I know it's here somewhere. Empty field 38. There you go. You can see we've got some mega monies coming in. I've spent quite a bit as well. I'll show you that in a second. Two combined courses. Got two courses loaded. Clear current course. Right. Add that. Okay. 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 Right. What have we been doing? Well, obviously why I've been, between episodes, I've been doing things, you know, little things. As you can see, this is progressing nicely over here. So we're actually getting a track called No, don't want that one. He's mucking about down here. Yeah, you'll do. Have we got another tree? We need another tree. So we never buy a new tree. What we need to produce diesel, because I've now found I'm a printout to tell me which things do which in the factory. So we need canola or rapeseed or oil seed, rapeseed, to produce diesel. Manure, get manure for different things, gives you money. Manure and sludge gives you money. Fertilizer, production for fertilizer, manure and slurry. Feed production, which is mixed rations. You need either hay, grass, silage, straw. Water, when we give it water, it produces money for us. Produces fertilizer, wood pallets, you just sell. So, yeah. All duty stuff like that. And yeah, you Okay, Derek. Right, we need a trailer. So, right. Let's have a look in mod trailers. I want a fairly biggish one. And they're not modded trailers. Cool. Come on, get a grip pan. Duh. Right, I've got the brand now. Yeah. No. Ah, this is... I put the Fliegl in. Because I've put in the saddleback, which I will buy at some stage. Which is a nice tractor, and they've updated it, which gives me great pleasure. So I have to buy one of them and show you all about it. We could buy this trailer, it's 33,000. The Dotty is 33,000. We could buy, I put in the Fortuna SA560. Which is 56,000, but it needs a dolly. I put in these ones, the MBJ Bitrim fronts and backs. You can actually connect these up. There's a bogey at the back that, you know, connects to this one, but you need a dolly for that. That's the saddle back one. So. Here's the other one. Lost it. No, that's just a truck trailer. A trucker trailer. So there's this West one, which is 2150. I need something bigger than that. I need something bigger than that. So it's... Let's have a look at this Fortuna. Okay. Quite a big trailer. Fortuna Molden Kibar. Quite nice. Nicely modeled. Yeah, so what we've done, we have put a few more trees in. That's what I'm expecting. There's more trees, we've got a bit bigger orchard going down here as well. It took me quite a long time as well. So we've got some more trees to go out to, which is great stuff. So we need to go and get some. Also, put back in my greenhouse. I'll show you where I put it. For kohlrabi, carrots and onions. I've figured out what is actually lagging the snot out of it. And if I be careful, it won't. But to actually change it to take the lag out, you've got to virtually redesign the plane in Giant's editor. And to be honest, it's not worth it. Right. I ploughed this down here and I've placed it in here. Right, what is lagging the snot out of things is when the carrots grow. Because there's so many leaves and on the carrots, it's causing such much trouble for the generation on the animation. That's what's actually doing it. If you look at the kohlrabi and onions is not too bad, but once you get to the carrots, it's a killer. So if you try and avoid looking at the carrots, yeah, try and avoid looking at the carrots. That is what the killer is. I've still got a greenhouse here that they're making money. They're the giant in-game ones. Our BGA is ticking along. So sometimes in some places I might keep my head down just to keep my frame rate up. Might not always happen, but this is what happens when you start adding mods and things. Majority of them work nicely, some of them do not. Right, what's new in Giants with Big Back Garden? Not a lot really. Their big thing at the moment, what they've announced, as I said last time, is Farming 16, which is on mobile. So if you like your mobile gaming, then Farming 16. I repeat, there is not a new Farming Simulator 16 for PC, it is mobile. There are still people that are getting confused, because they just see the number 16 and think, whoa, we're getting a new game. No, you're not getting a new game. Mobile version. It's like 15 when there might be a, you know, another new one for well, they did that on 14 I think for Vista and or the handhelds. I think that was right. Have we got any? Yes, we've got some canolas. We can whack some of that in. Let's just nip and sort this dude out. Do my barn. He's done one. That's where he's slipping. See? Now, here you are. Right, if I'd had a camouflage tractor in here, I'd never find it. I should get myself one. It's wrapped itself good, isn't it? What a donkey. Isn't it donkey? Dry balls, let's see what you make of that one. So he, because he got stuck, he was actually stopping the combine from actually triggering as well. So just be aware of that. Right, go back. Tab improves, sorry about that. So yeah, not much is coming out of the joints. The competition is still running till the end of the month, I think the 25th-ish of August, so we won't probably get to play from Woo until September-ish, maybe. Hopefully there's going to be some good mods whacking through. And yes, I've put a couple more water things. Let's just show you. I've chopped the trees down here. Yeah, I've turned that one around. These houses are workers, so they're not too bothered. I know old Inquirer was a bit worried about these people in these houses all of a sudden springing up a dirty great big factory complex. they're working on it, so you know, we sort of own the houses there, I guess, so they're not too much. Really, hopefully, we own them. One load here, canola. So that should start producing. Then we can get a tanker and fill it up, fill our tractors up, so we don't actually have to buy fuel anymore. Hopefully, that is one of the things, because fuel on this is quite expensive. So we can nip and get another trailer full. Wibbly wobbly da. Wibbly wobbly. So yes, I want to spend some money because I think we can do a new harvester. Got, look at 1.5 million, and I've upped my cows to 350, so should be getting some good money off of the cows. It takes quite a bit of looking after the cows now, but you know, that's good, it's worth it. I'm happy about it. I've got a couple more mods to show you down at the cows at some stage. Some people might not be excited, some people might. If you don't play with mods, I'll also show, because some people have asked about you know, normal, not modded silage making or mixed rations making for the cows, so I'll do that as well. The old in-game stuff I will use as well, which I don't mind using. And everybody thinks, oh, he's going to buy the auto snuffler. Actually, I am not. Because personally, it's a lot of money for not a lot of gain, really. Yeah, you can. It's got its own engine. It can snuffle up silage, but at the same stage, you've got to drop bales in anyway, or for your grass and that. Grass and straw, so you might as well. And it's got a smaller tank, so the one I'm going to use is the in-game one, which has got 18,000. Got 39 litres of fuel already now. That's wicked. Use that already. That's great stuff. But there you go, you know, producing their own fuel now. I know in Britain they've been trying it with farmers, you know, trying to get farmers to produce their own fuel for years. But it's never really took off, I don't think. Out of oilseed rape. They've wanted them to produce diesel to run their tractors and that. And it's never really took off. Right, while we're down here, we swing by the shop again. I don't know. Just mega money spending now. What we can go and buy in the shop. See, we used to be able to walk in the shop. I don't think I've ever. No, you can't walk in it no more. just got to stand outside and go,
"Hello, Mr. Salesman. Please, please, may I spend a few hundred thousand in your car park? Please." And they don't even let you in.
But they want millions of pounds of money, but they won't even let you in for a cup of tea. Not nice. Not nice at all. Let's have a look then. Let's have a look. I've got a Fendt, which is 12,000, but it's £400,000, which I think is a bit overpriced. So at the moment, I won't buy the Fendt. I mean, it's a nice model. It works. It works quite well. It's got a grain capacity of 12,300 and 3. That's more than 12,000, but it is 12,000. I think it's, 12,334. So, I could put other, but, we go for, what should we go for? We've got a case at the moment, haven't we? So, there, I think, I might go for the big New Holland. Why not? Yes. Shall we? See, the capacity is 12,330, which is exactly the same as the Fendt. So, in retrospect, a 400,000 not too bad price, actually. So, you know what? I am actually going to get the Fendt. I wasn't going to, but I will. Just so you got something else different to look at. I don't think there's any difference between... Oh, which one did we just buy? Oh, I just brought something. dear, I must have double-clicked it. I didn't really want the Terror Track, but hey, what the hell. We've just bought the Terror Track. The only thing is, with the header... the header is too small. I can't understand, because this is actually a conversion. So I'm going to do a wrong thing here. And I know it does work, because I've actually tried it. I'm actually going to go and buy the in-game header. Because in that model in 13, because it's a conversion from 13, obviously, used to have the 13.5 meter header on it, and now it hasn't. It's, I think it's only a 9 meter header or something on it, and for that capacity I think is wrong. So I'm actually going to buy the case header, and it does fit on it. I don't know whether it can tow it though. So we just spent £500,000. There you go, there's a Fendt for you. It's something different. It's not a bad model. He's in, if you was aware of it in 13, you know that nearly every month, I think, a new updated version of it came out. See, it sounds alright. Will it be able to take the header? I'm not 100% sure. Oh yes, it can attach it. That's nice. See, as I say, 13, he used to have this big header on it. But when he's gone into 15, he's dropped the header down. And no, the pipe is still rigged up for this big header. I was playing. It's got all the gizmos, you know, it's got your indicators and everything like that if you want it. we have a Fendt. I mean, it's quite rare to see a Fendt harvester, actually. It's something that everybody, there's lots of people that love John Deere, love Class, Fendt, but there was very few Fendt harvesters come out. There was only a couple. And as I say, the person that made this made several different versions of it. We're starting on this small field. No, we won't, because that's cool. That's cool. Okay, we come round here then. Duh, panda, you don't even know what we sow. Attach it. Maybe. Yeah, I'll put the pipe out for you, because as I say, you put 9 meter. We've got a on keypad KP8 flap. What's the flap? X is on fold. It's not. It's not bad. So we can open doors if we want. The open doors. We can open some flaps where. Oh, the flaps at the back, is it? Oh, look. Yeah, you can see in the engine. Yeah, cool. Good. Nice. Yes, the pipe. I will put the pipe out. The pipe is ever so long. I mean, it's designed really for this header. So you've got plenty of room to unload, you're not catching it. So that's why I've actually gone for this header, because I believe that this... I don't know why it didn't follow through with the... I know in 13 and most of the time, the header was what had a slight error on, so whether he ditched it or couldn't get it to work or not, I don't know. But let's just put it on the header and fold. So it looks a bit weird with a case header. Yeah, I know. On a Fendt. In my opinion, this is really the header that should be on it, not... Has it got? No, no. Just curious if it had withering wheels on. So we will... It's not a bad animation. It's nice looking. It's just a pity that it's got a red header instead of a green one. You know, a Fendt, a new Fendt 9460R combine. Yahoo! So there you go, Fendt fans. A combine harvester for you. Just cost me £500,000, but there you go. Around in circles, eh? Crazy. He also did a Massey version of it as well. Even more. We're gonna buy something different next time. I might gonna have to buy some more fields as well, because you know what we have to have to field. Sowing and cultivating with auto tractor. Let's just have a look at the big map. Big map. Number 9. Where would we like to go next? So we've got. We've pretty much got the bottom of the map. The fields are going towards. I suppose 15 would be a good one. Because we could put canola on 15 and feed our. Factory. 16 is quite big. Nineteen's a natural progression, I suppose. It's only a little field, though, isn't it? Nordics this one. Fendt's probably gonna go.
Oi! Where's me tractor gone?
That panda's just nicked it. He's a black and white thief. Around and we're are offloading a lovely wheat. Take care till next time. Bye bye for now.